What's really good about working at Remini is that everything changes every week. That's both the nature of AI, but also the approach we use for product development. Yeah, there were two major decisions that help us scale our product to more than 100 million monthly active users. The first decision was to narrow our focus on image enhancement. The second was the introduction of generative AI. AI photo enhancement is the ability to recover details from low quality or blurred pictures. When we acquired the app in 2021, we realized it had massive potential. Some of us tested it on a few photos of ourselves as children, and we really got in love with the technology. So we told ourselves, we need to make this feature front and center for every user so that everybody could experience the power of this technology.
For our team, it all became about the wow moment when you see your photos enhanced. Everything we did in the app was to bring users to that reward in a faster and more delightful way. We completely redesigned the interface to remove any of the possible distractions that were preventing users from easily accessing the enhancement feature.
Yeah, the idea is that if you work on 10 different features with 10 different value propositions, it's difficult to say which one you should work on. Instead, if you pick one, you narrow down the focus to one feature with a single value proposition, then it's easier to expand it in a more cohesive way. After we decided that we wanted to focus on photo enhancement, we really wanted to make the feature truly impressive. What we had to do first was to build a strong team of AI researchers because we didn't have one.
It was a critical moment for Bending Swans because Remini was the first product where AI was a critical part. So we had to establish all the processes and knowledge.
The first thing we did was to improve our enhancement model. We made it faster, improved its quality, and then we could focus on other features that were related to what users were coming to do on Remini. Color correction, background enhancement, portrait enhancement, background blur, you name them, I mean, a lot of features.
It was fascinating because in this period, we learned a lot. Every time we had a model we thought was working better than the previous one, we tested it and we discovered something new.
It all comes down to creativity and empathy. You need to understand what your users want and what they appreciate and then find the best way to make it possible.
We started working on generative AI in 2022 when the generative AI boom exploded. People were mainly coming to Remini to improve their portraits. So we thought, what if users could generate images of themselves, retaining their identity, and also be able to play with their imagination?
That's when really we added AI avatars into Remini. They were very cool, very creative, but also quite far from reality. And that's when we reflected and started to work on synthetic photography. Mid-2023, we released AI photos where people could actually generate photos of themselves and see themselves in new lights in different angles.
Yeah, people went crazy for it.
We launched a lot of it. It was a super intense period. Pregnancy filter, baby filter, clay filter, old money, a lot of content went viral.
We stayed at the top of the US App Store for 10 consecutive days. Because of all the work that we have done in the previous months, then we were able to actually keep the technology competitive. And to date, we really believe that the quality that we reached is top-notch.
Every day we are introducing people to completely new technologies for which they might not even have any conceptual basis. So before they even engage with Remini, we need to make sure that they understand what's even possible to do with it.
Yeah, just imagine that for most of our users, this is the first time they experience AI in their life.
We had to rethink the UI again and again, and now we are at the point where Remini is no longer an app that is driven only by features, but is driven also by content. The homepage, for example, we redesigned it completely to showcase all the content that we offer based on people's interest or even potential for virality.
I think people love Remini because we help them elevate their images, still preserving the true nature of themselves.
It does things that were far from our imagination even just a couple of years ago.
What is your favorite filter of all time?
Multi-avatar filter.
All the age-related filter, like aging video or baby me.
One we haven't released yet. Mm-hmm.